Should you avoid erythritol? Is there any connection between erythritol and heart attack, stroke, and cardiovascular disease? And how can you really be sure of that? Because the body can't really metabolize erythritol. What happens to it? But doesn't the body create its own erythritol through the pentose phosphate pathway? So what gives? These questions have really started only being asked, well, on the 27th of February when this study came out. It confused a lot of people who rely on these sugar alternatives either as part of the keto diet or are in need of a sugar that bypasses glucose and insulin pathways. In this video, let's take a good look at the study, understand erythritol platelets, and see if you really need to be worried. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I would love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Also guys, if you are on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now without wasting any more time, let's take a good look at the study. Here's the first problem. The people that are spreading the news on erythritol causing heart attacks really only look at this. Nature Medicine, the title, artificial sweetener and erythritol and cardiovascular risk, we get that, and let's highlight it. At physiological levels, erythritol enhanced platelet reactivity in vitro and thrombosis formation in vivo, which means not just in a test tube, but also in people. But here's what's funny. This is just the abstract. It's not the full study, guys. The full study is actually 28 pages long and looks like this. And you'll be shocked to see what's in it. But before we get into it, let's take a look at what really is erythritol and what happens to it in the body. Erythritol is already made in the body. In fact, it exists naturally in melons, grapes, and even asparagus. But the erythritol that is in food and drinks is made by fermenting glucose with a yeast-like fungi called Monilella polenis, getting you close to about 70% of the sweetness of table sugar. It's a four-carbon sugar mostly known for not affecting your glucose and insulin in the body. Now, once you ingest it, most of it gets absorbed into your bloodstream before it reaches your colon. It circulates in your blood for a while until it's eventually excreted in your urine. We as humans don't have enzymes to break it down, which is why it's considered safe, and to an extent we call it biologically inert, since our gut and bacteria don't even like to ferment it. It's kind of like it just passes through us. Exactly why you actually find it as a sweetener in sugar-free gum, because it doesn't cause any tooth decay. But for some reason, it causes platelet aggregation and cardiovascular events. Let's take a deeper look. Now, the first thing I look at in studies are the number of people in the study and what their past medical history was like. Here's what you're thinking. There's over 1,000 people involved in the study. Surely it's a big sample size. Not so fast, because here's the actual context. From 2004 to 2011, Dr. Hazen and his colleagues were collecting blood samples, right? And this was part of their database. In the first group of about 1,100 people who were undergoing cardiac risk assessments from their blood samples, they concluded from their studies that the more erythritol in a person's bloodstream, the higher their chances of suffering a major cardiac event like a heart attack or stroke would be during a 3-year period. Now, we don't even know that the details of the underlying conditions that already put them at risk for developing complications, right? You see what I'm saying? This is the old correlation does not equal causation fallacy. And to illustrate this, take a look at this graph that looks at ice cream sales and shark attacks to make more sense of it. You see how they're so closely correlated? So does that mean that consuming ice cream causes shark attacks? No, what it actually means is that more people consume ice cream and get in the ocean when it's warmer outside. That's all it means. Plus, the actual volunteers in this study were 8 people. Just 8. 8 is a sample size that is too small. It reduces the power of the study and increases the margin of error, which can render the study, hate to say it, meaningless. And to get to the bottom of this, to really be sure, you have to literally get to the bottom by scrolling down to the bottom, and I'll leave the link to the full study below. Scroll down to the bottom to this tiny section here, and what do you know? This study has not minor limitations, but several. This study itself is telling you that there's limitations, so read them before you get all caught up. What does it say? Measurement of erythritol in clinical cohort studies was only performed once as an overnight fasting level at the time of enrollment. So they don't even know if measurements throughout the day would have changed their findings. Secondly, because patients in our observational cohorts were recruited at quaternary referral centers and show a high prevalence of CVD and traditional risk factors, the translatability of our findings to the general population needs to be determined. This is huge, right? Were these volunteers already at risk of cardiovascular disease and they wanted to use them in order to get the results they wanted? Moving on. Thirdly, another limitation of our clinical observational studies is that by design, these studies can only show association and not causation, which we discussed earlier with ice cream sales and shark attacks, which is exactly what I was telling you guys. Fourthly, we also recognize the possibility of unmodeled confounding, for example, diet, that may have directly or indirectly impacted our results by factors that are not included in our models. Basically, it's a way of saying they didn't even account for what else the volunteers ate throughout the trial that could have skewed results in any which way. Now, the amount that they used on those 8 people was 30 grams of erythritol, which is about the amount in a pint of keto ice cream. And the levels of erythritol apparently remained 1,000-fold higher for hours after ingestion and remained substantially elevated for over 2 days. So the real question is, does that have any clinical ramifications that you should be concerned of? Here's my opinion. It's important to know that the appearance of erythritol in the blood before a cardiac event doesn't necessarily mean that the erythritol is causing that event, because our bodies produce erythritol on its own. It introduces a very high likelihood of what's called the third variable problem, in which the observed correlation between two variables, in this case, more erythritol, more cardiovascular events, can actually be explained by a third variable that hasn't been accounted for, which in this case would be the pentose phosphate pathway, which is already going to increase as a result of oxidative stress, inflammation, diabetes, obesity, that also impacts cardiovascular risk. And a good example of this is the following one. Cities with more fire hydrants tend to also have more dogs, right? That's the correlation, but there is a third variable that is causing that correlation, which is the population size of that city. Of course, you're going to have a correlation of more dogs and more fire hydrants because you have a larger city that's creating that correlation to begin with. Of course, larger cities have more dogs and more fire hydrants. That's just the covariate. Now, with that said, and with the study broken down, I can't tell you to eat or not eat erythritol. That's entirely up to you. The reason why I don't like it is because of the taste. It literally tastes too artificial for me. Which is why if I am looking for a sugar alternative, I'd start with allulose, xylitol, and monk fruit, for example. But I'm more curious to actually hear from you. What is your favorite sugar alternative? Do you have one, or do you believe everything is fine in moderation? Let me know in the comments below. Also, hit that subscribe button too if you found value in this, and I'll see you guys on the next one.